Hello everyone, Ranjita here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm here with the first video in the Crafty December series. For today, the prompt is old pages. If you want to know more in detail about Crafty December, check out my previous video in which I have mentioned all the details. Let's go ahead and check out what I'm going to make with these old pages. Also, don't forget to check out what my friend Manasa made with this prompt. The link to her channel is given in the description box below. Let's get started. Since the prompt was old pages, I decided to play around with these old books. For this project, you can use any kind of book, preferably one with at least 200 to 300 pages. More the number of pages, more fuller your end project would be. With this book, we are going to make a flower vase or a table centerpiece today. You could use kids' comics, old novels, textbooks, any book of any size of your choice. All you need is at least 200 to 300 pages to start off with this project. Firstly, I am removing the front hard cover here so that I will be left with only the pages with the raw spine of the book. In case if you're working with an old book, you can directly rip off the front page. But since my front page was quite intact, I am cutting it with a craft knife here. For this project that we are making a book folding vase here. For this project, you require a book with around 200 to 300 pages with a raw spine and just the pages in it. For this project today, I'm going to show you two different types of folds. So the first one is I'm bringing the right bottom corner of the page and I'm folding it like this into a triangle. And then I'm again taking the entire page and folding it in half. So you will have a smaller, more acute triangle here. The part of the page which is going above the book, we're going to crease there and we're going to fold it inward this way. So this will be our first fold. Moving on to the second fold, I am bringing the right top corner and I am folding it like this again into a triangle. And then I am bringing the bottom corner and I am joining it to the fold above. And I am folding this entire thing till here as shown in the video. This will form another smaller triangle here. So these are the two folds and your flower vase will have a shape like this. I'm going to show you again. So the first fold, we are starting off with the right bottom corner and then folding it again in half. Whatever paper is lying above or coming out of the book, we are going to fold it here. This will be our first fold. And the next page, we are starting with the right top corner, folding it into a triangle. And then we are again folding the right bottom into a smaller triangle and then completing it with another fold here. So these are the two folds that we are going to do and we are going to complete the entire book with making these folds. So we are going to do one page with the first type of fold and the next page with the second type of fold. So you will just go on alternating these folds until you finish the entire book and you reach the last page. For making this project, you need to be specific about some things. It is a very easy project, but definitely requires a lot of time and patience so that you can fold each and every page of the entire book. If you remember, as kids, we used to make partitions in our notebooks just in a similar manner. This is also a similar way of folding paper. But what you have to remember here is every fold you make should be sharp and crisp. That is, you cannot just rush through the folding. The more crisp your folds are, that is, you have to crease with your nail for every fold. Only then your vase will be staying in position. So though it is an easy process, you need to make sure that you fold each and every fold accurately. Otherwise, you will have some pages popping out of your other folded pages. So make sure you do not make such mistakes. Take your time and fold it each and every page properly in very well creased manner. That is it. This is all you have to keep doing for the entire book of 200 or 300 pages. just make a fold, the first type of fold that I have shown you, and then in the second page you're going to make the second type of fold. This is what you have to do for the entire book, alternating each fold. This is a very easy and relaxing process. Will keep your mind occupied for a while. You can also do this while watching a movie or while you are on phone or anything. You do not have to sit in one place and just dedicatedly do something to finish this project. So I'm going to quickly finish up the entire book by making these folds. I'm going to make the first type of fold and then I'm going to alternate it with every page with making the second type of fold. As you can see here, I am continuing to fold this book and it's getting more and more difficult to finish it because my vase is getting fuller and fuller. So this is when your process kind of gets slowed down, but make sure you crease every page properly in spite of the resistance you're getting from the already folded pages. This is a very, very easy project, even kids can do it. And people with absolutely no crafting experience can also end up making a beautiful home decor piece with just a simple book that was lying around. So next time you're planning to throw away a magazine or a book, make sure you give this project a try. You will be making a beautiful home decor piece for yourself. So here I'm folding the last page here, and with this folding all the pages is done. Since mine was a new book, or a comparatively new book, the spine was a little rigid, so I'm just managing to fold the spine a little bit. So to aid this, what I'm doing is I'm gluing the first and the last page. But if yours is an old book and a little worn out book, you do not have to do this. The pages automatically close down. Now that my vase is almost complete, I'm going to take it a step ahead by beautifying it a little bit more. I am going to jazz up this simple flower vase with some gold onto it. So to jazz up my flower vase, what I am doing is I am taking these mirror lace here. You can use cloth or anything, absolutely your choice. So here I am taking this mirror lace and I am gluing it with a hot glue gun. This not just beautifies it but also helps in keeping the pages equally distant and holding them together. I'm going ahead and adding these golden flowers here. You can add whatever you want according to your room ambience and all that. So here I'm adding these gold flowers. I will be attaching them with a glue gun. That's it. Our project is almost done. You can see the close-up images of the finished project here. It was so simple to convert this old book into this beautiful flower vase. I hope you liked this video and I was of some inspiration to you. This is how I carried my prompt of old book pages. I hope you liked it. I will be back tomorrow with another prompt and with another beautiful video for this crafty December. Make sure you check out the entire playlist and hold on to us. Thank you so much for stopping by. If you haven't done it yet, do consider subscribing to my channel and tap on the bell icon so that you get notified every time I post a new video. Also, do follow me on my social media. The links are given in the description box below. Thank you.